Hello everyone, I've got my own merch. I've got this one in several colors and also my catchphrase designed and many more to come. So go check them out, it would help me a lot. And also, well, let's face it, you would look very cool. Anyway, in this video I'd like to show you how I made my new solar panel. Okay, I designed this panel together with my colleague and friend Justin, who does not want to be on camera. This new panel is based on the first one I made, but with a lot of improvements. Justin did all the calculations and a lot of the research. Together we designed it and I solved the manufacturing issues. So together we form quite a good team. And we are making two panels, one for him and one for me. So we started by cutting a 1 mm thick aluminum plate into collector panels. We did this at the workshop of my friend Jan, with whom I made the vortex cannons I showed in an earlier video. And after that, it was time to start cutting and bending on the housing of the panel. We made the housing out of 2 mm thick aluminum plate. Although bending the floppy aluminum plate made it much more rigid, the corners needed to be fixed together to also make the housing rigid along the diagonal axis. Okay, so these corners are now nicely fixed together with two blind rivets and some caulking. So now we'll seal these edges with the same caulking to make it completely watertight. Okay, so unlike my previous solar panel where the collector was completely made out of copper, this solar panel will be made out of copper pipe and aluminum plate. To the copper pipe, the aluminum plates will be attached with blind rivets and silicone caulking to conduct the heat. So this is the copper pipe I'm going to use. And of course you can't solder aluminum to copper. So I'm going to glue it with silicone caulking. It's going to be mounted like this in this groove. And there's going to be another plate on the other side, like so. And then it's going to be attached with blind rivets. And to make the space in the aluminum plate for the 10mm copper pipe to fit in, I made this mold. It makes this groove into the aluminum plate over the whole length. And it was quite a challenge, so I will now explain you how I did that. So this is the positive side, and this aluminum plate is being slided in to this mold. And we have this steel plates here as the negative side, and this is the positive side, so this fits in here. And then with the vise, I press the positive side into the aluminum plate, and I do it in 3 times. So this plate passes 3 times through the mold, so I can do it in stages, because if you press it in completely, then you get a result similar like this, where you can see that this is too deep, and this is the right depth. Because the first time you press it to the right depth with the first portion of the positive mold. So the first portion is pressed in completely, like so, and then you go to the second part, and this is then completely flat. So this portion is pressed in to the right depth, but it takes this portion with it a little bit. So that makes this part a little bit deeper than you need it to be. And of course, then you need to fill it with more silicone, which means more resistance and more ugly. So, if you do it in 3 stages, you just gently bend the whole plate into the right form. So I will now show you how I do it. And this whole mold is attached via these screws and steel strips. And it's actually quite sturdy. That keeps it fixed to one side of the vise, which makes it of course a lot easier to handle. Okay, so I begin with this 1mm aluminum plate. I slide it in here. This fits quite nicely, but not too tight. And I open the vise. Now I just gently squeeze it. And the first one needs to be bent back, because else that corner will bite into the guide. Normally I know it would stand where you are standing, but I don't want to move the tripod, so this is very handy. The first one is a bit rough because it deforms so much. And of course a little bit of lubrication would help, but then I later need to remove it for gluing it. So I try to avoid that. So that's the first one done. So you can see now that this slight bend. So now we'll go through it another time. Now we go a little bit further. This one is already going a little bit easier. So So now it looks much more like the end result, but it's not quite there yet. It needs to be a little bit deeper, needs to be a little bit tighter. Now we'll let it pass through again, and then it will be finished. Now really clamp it down. Okay, beautiful. So now the copper pipe will fit in here so that as much surface area of the aluminum plate will touch as much surface area of the copper pipe for optimum heat conductivity. And I need to do about 42 like this. So I'm now halfway. So I'm now going to put in a little bit more elbow grease, very greasy elbow here. And when it's finished, and then we need to punch holes in it and stuff, so still a lot to do. So back to work. Okay, so all these aluminum plates now have a groove on, so that's nice. And now I have to drill holes to rivet them together with blind rivets. So I've made this mold, and I have a groove in here where this aluminum plate can fit in. And then I put this 10 millimeter rod in. This is to simulate the copper pipe. And then I put another aluminum plate over it, like so. And I have this other wooden piece with also a groove and these holes in it. I'm gonna lay that on top here, like so, and clamp it down. And these aluminum plates I will keep together, I will number them, so there will be a set that belongs together, because then I don't have to deal with variations in positions of the holes, because later when I will assemble the solar panel, I don't want to have problems with hole position variation. So now let's drill some holes. Okay, the holes are now all drilled, and now I need to cut out a piece of aluminum from this plate, because the copper pipe has a bit of a radius on the surface area of the aluminum plate, if that makes any sense. That's because I wanted as much surface area covering the whole inside of the panel. So I thought, well, I can then knock in a bit of a radius here so that the copper pipe will fit in here. But eventually that was a little bit too much work. Wasn't gonna look nice, so I just thought, well, let's cut off a piece. It's just a few square centimeters per panel that you miss in surface area, so that doesn't really matter. So I will now show you how I do that. And of course it would be a lot easier if I had cut out this corner before I made this groove, but yeah, that's how it goes sometimes. So I made this little mold. I can fit it in here, and it has the right dimensions, so I can just scratch out a line here, and then with my plate scissors I can just cut out a piece. Like so. And of course now it's a bit damaged. So I'm gonna use this thing again. And then I'll just shove this in here again. Just squeeze it a bit. And then it looks okay again. So, I will now do all the 40 panels. Fun, fun, fun. So then, after 2 months of Corona break, it was finally time for assembly. And we started by cutting and gluing in these 2 cm thick polyurethane insulation plates. Now you don't necessarily need to insulate the housing because the collector is removing the heat so efficiently that the amount of energy lost through the housing is negligible. But it's not that expensive and it helps making the panel more rigid. And as a plus, it makes it a bit more efficient if you are heating the water to a higher temperature or when it becomes freezing cold outside. So then it was time to bend copper pipe on top of this template I made. Justin calculated that with a 10 mm pipe, which has an 8 mm inside diameter, and with a flow rate of 480 liters per hour, the water flow becomes turbulent and therefore the water is able to absorb more energy. That's because if the flow would be laminar, then only a thin layer of water touching the pipe would be heated and all the water in the middle of the pipe would be heated much less. With a turbulent flow, the water is constantly mixed so all the water is heated up evenly, which makes it absorb more heat over time. The opposite works to prevent cooling of the water when transporting it to your hot tub or whatever you want to heat, and with a flow rate of 480 liters per hour and a pipe diameter of 60 mm, the water will become laminar, so that helps to prevent heat loss. Then we started fixing the collector panels to the copper pipe with blind rivets and silicone caulking. We used the silicone caulking to conduct the heat from the aluminum plates to the copper pipe. Without the silicone, there wouldn't have been a lot of places where the aluminum and the copper would have touched, which means that there would mostly have been an air gap, which works as an insulating layer. Silicone conducts that heat much better, so that solves the problem pretty well. There are better heat conducting materials than silicone, but they are more expensive and harder to find, and the layer of silicone is very thin, so it will probably work fine. Thank you. Okay, that's it for this video. We will finish the panel in an upcoming video. So until that time, thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Turn on the notification bell so you won't miss an episode. And see you next time.